Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and today it's a new top 5 video, and I am going to show you. I'm going to start with eyeshadows now, and these are going to be, I think, 3 different top 5 eyeshadows. So now I'm going to start with matte neutrals, and I just understand that I have a blue makeup and not neutral at all. I don't care. So I'm going to start with my top 5 neutral matte eyeshadows, the brands I like the most, and then I'm going to do neutral colorful and colorful shimmers, and I think I'm maybe also going to do neutral shimmers. I have not decided. You can comment if you want 4 or 3 different videos, and I'm going to start with matte neutral shades, and I think it's going to be the same brands in some of the videos, but I think I will start with the matte neutrals because this feels like the easiest one. The colorful mattes is going to be hard, and I want to save that for another day. So I will start with my top 5 matte neutral eyeshadows, and I don't know which one I'm going to start with. I start with Nabla. I don't think this is a surprise for you that I love Nabla's matte shadows, and I love their single shadows the most. I have heard other people say that, but I think their single shadows are the best shadows they have. It's nothing wrong with the palettes, but their matte single neutral shadows, like this, the matte collection, these are so good. It's such great shadows, they are so easy to work with, so easy to blend, so easy to build up, so easy to... Yeah, they are just so easy to work with, and they have a lot of shadows, and I think that Nabla's single shadows should have more... People should talk about them more because they are great. So I can really recommend these if you want matte, neutral, good shadows. And these are pretty big as well. I don't know how much they contain. 1.8 grams, so it's a pretty big shadow, and these are so good. The next brand is, of course, Anastasia Beverly Hills, and I took the Soft Glam palette, and I don't know why you do this velour thing to your palette, because it's going to get so dirty. It's pretty dirty. I hope you can't see it. I don't think you can. So the Soft Glam, these neutral shadows are amazing. I love the burnt orange, I love the orange Shoda, I love the Sienna, I love the rustic. They are so good. They almost blend themselves, and they are so creamy for being matte. And the Soft Glam and the Modern Renaissance, they are the same in formula, and both the matte and the shimmers. The Prism and the Subculture, that they are a little bit more dry, but they are also good. But the Soft Glam, this is a wonderful neutral palette. It's so freaking good. The mattes are wonderful. I don't know if the single shadows from ABH is the same as in this one, but if they are, they are super great as well. Next up, we have a brand that I don't talk about as much on my channel, and that is Makeup Geek. Makeup Geek is one of the first brands I've tried that was not like an easy brand to get a hand of in Sweden, or like Urban Decay or something. My first Makeup Geek shadow I bought from Makeup Geek's own website for like 4 years ago or something. But they are so good with matte shadows. I almost only have matte shadows from Makeup Geek, but they are some of my favorites. One of my absolute favorite is Latte. It's this one, but also these orange. They are so good. So this is only Makeup Geek shadows, and they are so, so good. Next up, we have Urban Decay, and this maybe sounds a little bit strange because I don't talk about Urban Decay that much, but Urban Decay was the first expensive brand I ever tried, and when I tried the Naked 2 for the first time, I was like, so this is what you pay money for? Because their shadows are so good. It feels like people don't like Urban Decay as much anymore, but they are really good with doing matte neutral shades. Here I have the Gwen Stefani palette. I don't know if it's just Urban Decay Gwen Stefani. And these shadows are super great. I really love this one. And also this one. They are great. Urban Decay is really good with doing boring shades. And the last one is Linda Hallberg's Cosmetics, of course. This is one of my favorite brands, and this is the Infinity palette. These shadows are amazing. One of my top eyeshadows of all time is this Swiggy. That is an amazing shadow, and also this Maffei. This I'm using for contour right now, and it's really good for me that are this pale. For somebody it maybe look like a powder or anything, but for me it's a contour shade and it works so good. These shadows are really, really, really good. These four are mattes and these four are shimmers. Did you hear that? The car was braking so hard. Okay, so we're only talking about this four, and I can really recommend this palette for everybody. This I use this mostly for my face, but also for my eyes. And this is such a good palette. The shadows are really amazing. They are easy to blend, easy to work with, and look so good on the eye. So that was my top 5 matte neutral eyeshadows, formula, brands, things, and this seems like a messy video, but I really hope you liked it. And I will do at least one matte colorful eyeshadow top 5 and one shimmer or glitter. And I don't know if you want both matte, no, oh my god, I am going to do one. Okay, maybe I just have to think before I say anything more. And if you want with shimmers, do you... And I'm also doing it with shimmers, and I don't know if I should do colorful shimmers and neutral shimmers or just shimmers. You can write and comment what you think if you want one or two videos with shimmers, and I will fix that. So I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do so you don't miss any of my videos. Bye!